A great man shows his greatness by the way he listens to another. So when a great man speaks, listen.
Norm is the shell answer man.
This is a story.
That's a guy that knows everything.
Of how Mitch Payton gave his good friend his youth back. Mitch has been good friends with Norm for just over 30 years.
Norm spent 30-some years working for Kawasaki and
came to pro circuit, been here almost 10 years.
He used to race motocross, then jet skis. You sort of wouldn't know it unless you start talking to him about it.
Became a motocross racer.
Jet ski,
wave jumping,
stuntman,
and surfing. And went to Hawaii and rode the big surf there.
Yeah, Norm's the don around here.
He's totally a jokester. That's what keeps us smiling and laughing every
day. He's the wise guy that makes a lot of changes to our bike.
I can't say Papa, but I would say he's the best good friend. I can't make him feel old.
With a youthful spirit and a lifetime of action sports, Norm's body has been beat.
Along the way, discovered cycling.
He was younger, he was a hammerhead, just always out there on the road bike.
I was extreme sports when it was just having a good time, I guess.
Norm's done his shoulders, knees, hips, everything. He walks a little bit with a limp.
Tell people, I have good ankles, and that's it.
Cycling is the last sport from Norm's past that he could still be a part of. He would ride his bike during the lunch breaks. It turned into the lunch rides when the rest of the crew joined. Then they got faster than him.
Norm would struggle when we went on bicycle rides before because he's always a little bit behind and stuff.
Mitch watched the lunch crew come back from the rides and noticed Norm was exhausted.
There's times when my knees hurt, where on a bicycle I can't stand up. Yeah, I want to do it mentally. I want to get up off the seat and hammer and get on the drops, but I haven't been on the drops on the bars in 10 years.
That's when Mitch knew he had to do something to keep Norm from giving up on one of his last passions.
Like before, we would be like, come on, Norm, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. And now it's like, Norm, slow down, slow down. Sucks. That sucks. He probably still has that wrench of mine. Norm!
I asked Curtis, I'm like,
what's up with this Creo SL, like, road bike? And
it's not for me. Don't want it free. I want to pay for it. We want to give it to Norm so he could continue to ride.
That Norm guy kills me every lunchtime. I hate that guy. Do I actually hate him? No, I love him really, but at lunchtimes, I hate him.
Mitch basically pulls the trigger and says, I want to buy it. Norm has no idea, and Mitch wants to surprise him.
I don't know exactly when I told him, but like...
He goes, look what I got you. And I was just in shock.
Brought a new life out to him.
It's a whole new game, you know, I'm back in the game.
It's like cheating. It's as fast as I can go. Woo!
It's good because now when we ride, he kicks our asses.
My heart rate is maxed. It's the greatest thing for him because he gets to talk to us.
Not bad for 67 Norm, huh?
While we're struggling, that's what vibes him.
Where you can wear them out a little bit, you know, make it just enough to where they're trying to catch you. Hear them panting in the background, just speed the thing up and away you go.
Come on, Norm, give me a tow. Get on in.
That was 310 watts.
Woo!
It's an amazing piece of equipment. It's like going back in time.
Of course I love that guy. Dude, he's special to me.
I'm pretty amazed that we're doing this. You know, I'm just Norm in the back.
Can you imagine having the same bicycle for about 25 years and then you get this badass thing?
Mitch especially knows when we stop doing what we love, it's usually in fault of injury.
This is how he's getting it done, and you can't argue that. I know so many people that would just like tap out. Norm's not tapping out, he's still chucking along.
So all Mitch did was listen. Now Norm can be himself again, only faster.
I'd always say, just keep going forward. Somehow, have fun while you're doing it.